Okay. Enough selling charity. Let's Witcher it up. So, when I was out exploring, oh, see, there we go, testimonial. Somebody said, donated a flock of chickens yesterday and told my wife about it. Both felt awesome and talked lots about heifer all day. So, see? Yay! First time donor. So I was out exploring, and I found this place. I'll show you here on the map. Dragon Slayer's Grotto. So, my gut is that this is going to be, like, way more than I can handle at this, like, at my level 7-ness here. Come on. Can't even see what I'm fighting. A bunch of wraithness here. I think I'm gonna switch to this sign. Maybe actually. That's a relatively esoteric change. I found a place of power that allows me, that like doubles the power of one of my signs, and that's a skill that I have that keeps that as a permanent feature. So if I'm gonna fight a bunch of wraiths in here, I'll need to use that maybe more than a little bit. Oh, now look at that. That's a cool thing. A couple of years ago, instead of giving presents, we were able to get a water buffalo. And I turned the picture of a water buffalo into a puzzle, and everyone got a piece to assemble it and see it on Christmas. That is an amazing way to do it. That's a really, really cool thing to do. One year, I got my mom a llama, and I drew her like a really awful picture of a llama. I did it in crayon. I was in my 30s, mind you. But she loved it. She loved it. And once, like, a bunch of friends crashed at our house, and they're like, "What sort? Should we get your parents some wine? Should we do that as a favor?" And I'm like, you know, they would, you know. I go, "My mom loves Heifer International." And so they all got together and they donated, they pooled their money, and they all drew her a different picture of the animal they got. I think it was, gosh, I think it was a sheep. I can't remember. I can't remember. Maybe it was an alpaca. Right now, all of these Witcher sessions are archived here on Twitch, so you can watch them there. If you win something and you want to leave it in the next charity auction, I don't know. Email Worldbuilders that question. Gonna use some Spectre oil. Does Spectres even work against wraiths? Elemental, cursed. See, I don't like having 27 goddamn oils. Especially because it only gives you a 10% bonus. That's a lot of fucking hassle. I am the founder of Worldbuilders. What I get to use. I wish there was more of this in the game because I love it. Kapow! Okay, I was not being careful. I was answering too many questions in chat rather than healing. I like the potion making in the first one a little better. You had to incessantly like gather herbs and like stockpile your potions, but when you use them, like they were really effective. Oh, I will be able to upgrade these oils. That's good for me to know. Hold on, that's. Hold on, there's a secret tunnel here. Or not. On. Did you put your fucking... Look at... Geralt doesn't even have his sword out, you dumbass. Boy, I wonder why everything's killing me. Maybe it's because you haven't drawn your sword. You know what? I was just gonna let him die. I was just gonna punish him by letting him die like he deserves. Oh, look at this. So, this is something I found when I was... Wow. Okay. Nice loot here. But while I was looting some farmer's house, not that I condone that sort of behavior, look what I found here in my food slot. Butter. It's just like a tub of butter, and I thought, like, oh, I can use that for making oils, right? And decoctions. Nope, it's food. So the next piece of... the next consumable on my list is just a tub of butter. When Geralt is hurt, he's gonna apparently decide to just eat a fucking tub of butter to regenerate hit points. Magic sword? Oh, I'm sad that it's not as good as my current sword. Yeah, not nearly as good. Although it's got an Igni boost. Better critical hit. No, it's still not worth it. Yeah, this is a treasure-rich environment. Spectre oil. I like how it's like diamond dust, runes of power, cotton. You know, here's some thread. These are actually some pretty nice rune stones, too. So this is interesting. If you came in here and you were like, la la la, what a lovely batch of treasure. I fought some hard monsters. I'm gonna eat this butter. Delicious butter. I've got all these wraith mutagens. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them. You know, I apologize for this, guys. My phone just went off. It's muted. But, I think it might have been Sarah, so I have to look at the message she left. Also, guys, we're looking for suggestions for other things or games I can do tomorrow. If you want to make a suggestion, I'm probably going to do some Witcher no matter what, but, you know, make suggestions for other games or talks or things that you think would also be a good time. This is the perfect moment for it because I've got to see. Okay, everything is fine. More Goat Simulator. I think I've really plumbed the depths of what Goat Simulator has to offer for me. See, I don't feel as proud finding that, seeing that like up on the screen, the mini map actually gives it away. That's treating me like a real idiot. Let me see, Ard. Oh, so it's all poison in there.
Come closer.
On. Shit. Oh, damn it. Reset these wraiths after my save? That's a little odd. Man, is there a giant fucking dragon in there that's gonna just molest me? What the hell are you? Hey, red mutagen. Oh. So this is a kind of vampire. I'm gonna see if there's a bestiary entry about these things. No. Oh, vampires. Vulnerable to vampire oil, devil's puffball, and igni. Okay, I like using igni already. Do I have vampire oil? Ho ho, look at me. Just because I relentlessly craft everything that I can. Decoction. Let's see, look at this. I killed this thing and I got this mutagen that I need to make this decoction. Decoctions are like really super powerful potions. I might use that one. Yeah, there's all these decoctions that I can't make. Immunity to poison. I'm going to make this just in case I need it. I think there's some potion that I have. Tawny owl. It makes my blood injures vampires and necrophages when they wound me. You know, maybe I'm gonna throw this into the mix. What the hell? Whoa. You just straight up killed me without even looking at me. That thing was fucking huge. No, I saved. No. Okay, good. I thought that it started me all the way back. Okay, this may not be a good place for me to have a saved game, apparently. Big Daddy Vampire apparently is super pissed. The Leshen should not be there. I agree, he should not. How about I super ass run myself away? Look at that, it sealed up the fucking wall behind me. Oh, Bebo, just email Worldbuilders and they'll change your donation setting. That's not a big deal. Well, let's try it one more time. Maybe what I can do is I'll lure him more into this. Fuck, I don't know. That thing just kind of one-shots me. Okay, do I have the potion that makes me immune from poison? Doesn't look like it. See, the problem is, I'm gonna have to freeze him, and then while he's frozen, like, three different, I'm gonna have to use fire. Ugh, Christ. Let's try it. Come on, use your fucking... I don't know if there's a way out on the other side of the room, or if it's just like further in and there'll be more vampires to wreck my day. I thought about going in and maybe these guys will fight each other, but that seems to be hoping for a little much. Yeah, I'll load an earlier save. I just want to try. Almost got him. Am I free? Is this an illusion? Can I get out? I don't see, what the hell is this? Is this a sign I'm supposed to recognize? It's not one of my magic signs. Can somebody tell me without spoiling things that, like, this is something you have not picked up the appropriate quest line yet? You have to use the lantern from Kira to dispel it. Oh man, he's down there. Like a big old dick. Go away! You're keeping me from looting my chests. Maybe he teleported away. Like he teleported into my life, making me super sad. I'm gonna save the game here. Olives. Okay, from this we learn that vampires love booze. Witcher, George, ooh, Griffin armor. All sorts of Griffin stuff. Forgive me if I quickly look at well, I might be able to, in a couple of levels, start using this stuff. It's about a billion times better than a lot of my current armor. Although it's all medium. I prefer the light armor. Super nervous to go down these stairs again. so much booze in this world. Look at that, it reset that wall. There's a weird glitch in there. Oh! Did you see what happened? Ha ha ha! No, don't die on me. Don't die on me, Witcher. Get out of there. Run. Did you see what happened? Yeah, I know. I'm caring too much because I looted everything in there. The Leshen went in to that poison hallway and sat there in the poison until it died. And so, as a result, I get, it's like swank Leshen. I don't get the experience for killing it, unfortunately. But, like, if I go over here, I bet you it's gonna show up here. There's a mutagen. Mutagen. An alchemy. Now there's this one that I knew about. There's a Leshen decoction. See, it probably didn't give me this mutagen. Maybe because I didn't kill it personally. So, anyway, I feel pretty good about that. Sometimes running away is the answer. I looted its charred remains. I'm just glad I walked back there and did it. So, now... There. Oh, I thought, damn it. I thought I missed a wraith corpse. So I went back to pick up the sword that I just dropped. Yeah, you can't kill it from afar with arrows when it's chasing you in a narrow tunnel, unfortunately. It teleports up to you and then apparently puts its big, rooty foot up your ass, so... So... I have date night with Sarah tonight, so I'm going to kind of play until she shows up. But then when that happens, I'm out. Thank you again for tuning in to the stream. Also, I will, because I probably won't do it at the end, I will encourage you to please, I'll actually pause it here and hop over to look at Worldbuilders. We were at 350. Okay, another $1,000. That's some good progress, some donations in the Twitch stream. I'm going to go buy her some nice food, and we're maybe going to watch Doctor Strange. And I will let her know about the parenting chat. Please do consider coming in and donating. The matching money alone should be enough of a motivator, and if not for that, we've got a bunch of stuff in the fundraiser. You can win a favor from me, some of my, absolutely impossible to find older editions of books, a ready-built fantasy library with all of the best. There's a full set of Sandman in here, of Terry Pratchett, of Jim Butcher, Raymond Feist, the Chronicles of Master Leon number 10 Ox, which we had to work to find it because that's out of print. You can win that in the lottery. You can win this beautiful tack set in the lottery. Every 10 bucks you kick in is matched and gives you a chance to win cool stuff. So please, please, please do it. I would really appreciate it. And trust me, you will feel better about yourself and you'll feel better about the world. I was just gesturing at the screen like you could see it. Except you can't, because we're still looking at the Witcher holding a torch and looking super manly with his ruggedy beard. It is 4:00. I think, Sarah will be here shortly. Maybe I should pretty myself up a little bit for her if we're having date night now and we've had our full 3-hour stream. It's possible that I will come on a little later tonight and do a little more streaming. It's more possible if a bunch of people jump in and donate in the Twitch stream. Hint, hint. Thank you. Thank you so much for showing up. If you have any last minute suggestions for tomorrow's stream, we'll be putting up the votee very shortly. I'm going to call Amanda as soon as I'm done here. As a matter of fact, why don't we just say, how about we do more children's books? Because people suggested that. And we'll do children's books and Overwatch, okay? That will be the votee. That'll be the votee for tomorrow. Overwatch, so you can watch me play Overwatch, Witcher, and children's books. Those will be the votes for tomorrow. Okay? So Amanda will throw that up, and as soon as you start donating, you can go vote on that. We will do an Infocom game stream later. That's a great suggestion as well. And Yeah, I've heard good things about Doctor Strange. Don't give anything else away. I do not want to play Dark Souls. I don't think it's just not my sort of game. There is plenty of clarification as to how the donation raffle worked. Please just read the blog. I've said it like 100 times. I don't want to try to explain it again. I talk about it all the time here on the blog, if or on the stream. If that's not enough for you, get it like directly off the blog. There's detailed explanations on the Hub blog. I've seen the Scribblenauts explanations a couple of times, or suggestion a couple of times. I don't know. I don't know if that would be a ton of fun. Maybe I might do that with my little boy sometime. No, that's not your problem, but somebody can throw up a link to the blog so you can see it in detail there. And here's Sarah. So, oh, she'll poke her head in here if you want to see her prettiness. Oh, they can't see you. You need to look over there. See? Hi. Oh, you look kind of Amish in your hat.
I'm going Amish.
Going Amish?
Mm-hmm.
That sounds super hot. On that note, thanks so much for tuning in. Amanda's going to throw up the Vody. When she gets that Vody up there, she will let you know here in the chat. Assume that will be done in about 10 or 15 minutes, and then you can go vote. You can go donate and vote with your donation for what we're doing tomorrow. Again, thank you so much, and I will see a lot of you soon.